Johnny Knoxville, welcome to the Tonight Show. I'm so happy to have you here, bud.
Well, happy to be here.
It's always fun seeing you because I got to see you. You helped me out on my other show, Password.
And don't show the first episode.
We have to.
I did so bad on the first episode.
No, you didn't. Like,
oh, no, I did terrible. Second episode, I did a little better, but oh, boy.
Were you that bad?
No, yeah, no, I was really self-conscious.
You were?
Yeah, it was terrible.
You were fantastic. You're charming. Everyone loves you.
Come on, come on.
Oh, you are. You know what? You posted something online that I loved. You actually played Ken before, which I didn't know. And I didn't... Yeah, I mean, we just had Ryan Gosling out here, and you played Ken before he did.
Playing my role.
Yes, he took... Yes, right. He played your role famously made by Johnny Knoxville when you played Ken. But can you...
It was my first thing I ever got. It was a video for Tom Petty. Phil Jouan, who directed Rattle and Hum, was directing. And I played a Ken doll. And I almost got fired because... It was on a rotating stage, and Tom Petty stood in the middle and sang his song, and the stage revolved around him, and everything that happened was in the background. But the stage broke for like 3 hours, and someone was like, hey, let's go get stoned at my house. And I was like, okay. So we all
you
went and got...
You didn't even think about it. You just said yes.
Yeah. So we all went and got stoned for a couple hours. We come back, and they'd fixed the stage within 30 minutes. And they were just...
You've been gone for 2 hours. You're like, oops.
Oh, it's so embarrassing. It was so bad.
But Tom Petty, do you go, this is exciting. Tom Petty, he's super cool.
He was so nice.
Yeah.
He was so nice. I ended up, they were rehearsing and the stage was rotating. I went up and I was singing into the mic because it was one of my first jobs. I didn't know you were not supposed to do that. But Tom came up behind me and was laughing and joking around. Yeah. I ended up getting to do a... King of the Hill with Tom Petty years later, and I just loved the guy.
Me too.
And so, and he's how you wanted him to be. You know how you, sometimes you meet people and they're exactly...
I know exactly what you're talking about.
So
you know,
he was great.
You just want Tom Petty to be just cool and, hey, man, how you doing? And he kind of is that.
Yeah, so it's kind of cool to almost get fired off his set for being stoned.
Yeah, that's interesting. But then... We actually got a still from the video, and I go...
Oh, no, it's so embarrassing. Okay, it's my first thing I told everyone.
Wait,
this is my big thing, you know? Yeah. And it came out, and this girl at work, Crystal, I was waiting table, she goes, yeah, it came out. And I'm just like, I couldn't tell you because they didn't have long focus. Show a picture of what actually...
It's in the video. You don't know how it feels. You don't know how it feels.
To be me.
Yeah. And here he is, Johnny Knoxville as Ken. Get ready, everyone. Oh, there you go. Unbelievable. Wow. That was... I'm getting teary-eyed.
I was actually really bummed.
I'm getting teary-eyed remembering this performance. Were you bummed? Did you just go, wait?
Yeah, because I just like, I'm not going to work ever again, probably.
And that's
was
my big
the closest
break.
I ever got to Hollywood.
Pal, everyone clearly knows you from Jackass, the TV series, but also the great movies you did.
Oh, great. Great.
By the way, you know what I was going to say to you? I don't know if I did say this to you when I saw you last time, but you know, any of those new goggles, the VR goggles, or like the Apple Vision Pro, the number one movie or number two movie that they go like, you won't really want to see 3D experience, it's Jackass. It's you. Dude, you're on the Meta glasses. You're on any new technology. Like, you want to see cutting edge technology? It's always you.
Why would you want to do that to yourself?
You
have things coming at you that really shouldn't come
be.
At you. You know? It's like, but there's a lot of perverts out there. That's
no,
why.
No, yeah. Man, oh, man. It is so funny. You know what you do. It's brilliantly. It's next level. It's three levels above anything you have
maybe
to do.
Maybe below.
Oh, my gosh. Fans want to know, will you ever do another Jackass movie?
I don't know. I still write ideas for it just because I have a lot of time on my hands.
Yeah.
But I don't know if we'll ever do another one. It's kind of you get the feeling and then let's do another. So I don't know.
Okay. Would you do the stunts still?
No, I made a promise to my kids that I wouldn't do any more stunts where I'm going to get another concussion. I've had too many concussions. I don't care if, like, I, you know, break my arm or wrist or anything, but I can't have any more concussions.
All right, so any stunt, no concussions involved.
Yeah, but everything else I'm up for.
Yeah. I want to talk about your new movie, by the way. But before that, you also have a podcast called Pretty Sure I Can Fly.
Yes. What an original idea to start a podcast.
Yeah. I've never... You're always on the cutting edge.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah.
You're the last person on Earth. Everyone in our audience has a podcast. It's amazing. But I know, but this actually, this is fascinating. And I even love the title, by the way. Pretty Sure I Can Fly. What is that? What
it's
is that?
From a Guy Clark song called The Cape. And it's a little kid got a, you know, a homemade cape around his neck. And he's going to jump off the garage. And he's pretty sure he can fly.
Yeah.
So, and the show's about... I guess the short version is people with more balls than a bowling alley. I like to see what makes them tick because they're doing things that people said, there's no way in hell that you're going to be able to do this and you shouldn't.
Yeah.
So stop.
Yeah.
And they continued with their dream. And
then they did it.
They did it.
Yeah, and I'm pretty sure I can fly. And guess what? You did fly. It's kind of awesome.
It's great.
But I want to talk about your new film. Sweet Dreams is the film. And you play a little softball in this, which you're really good at, by the way.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah, you are. Are you a
softball? I think everyone's good at softball.
No. Sadly, I played last night with the crew, and I'm terrible at softball. I'm so bad. I should have called you last night to show up. We went to a field.
Oh, man. That would have been, I love it. Baseball was like the only thing I was ever kind of good at. And,
yeah, yeah, I can
and
see that.
Then, so this movie came, I'm like, oh, yeah, sure.
What position did you play?
I pitched and played first base.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I played third base for a little bit, and then I got a bad hop. And
oh, yeah.
I think I got a concussion there, yeah. I was like, it was rough. And I go, I'm just afraid of baseball now.
They put me at third base for one game, and I could catch it, but I would get so excited and just throw it over the fence.
Yeah, yeah.
You know?
Just, you go, yeah, you go.
Let's put him back on first where he doesn't have to throw it so much.
Yeah, yeah, that's smart. Yeah, exactly. Because you get the ball, you go, that was enough.
No, I'm just like, ah!
Isn't that great? I caught it. Yeah, you go, no, they have to throw it the first now. Yeah, it's so hard. Can we set up the movie, what it's about and who you play?
Yes, I play Morris, and he's fighting to get his life back and his daughter back. He's going into rehab. He's burned the candle at both ends, which I personally never have. I'm joking.
This is it's a real stretch for you.
Yeah, yeah, real stretch.
A real stretch for you, yeah. No, but you, honestly, it is actually, you're getting great reviews for a great performance.
Thank you.
There's one scene in there, you told me that your actual daughter was giving you lines off camera.
Oh, my God. My oldest daughter, Madison, worked on the film. And in the movie, you know, my 10-year-old daughter, she would read the lines for my 10-year-old daughter. And every time I'd hear her little voice, I would just crack and start welling up because, you know, she's my baby.
Yeah.
So, So yeah. I've gotten, like, way more sentimental as I got older. It's embarrassing. Like, it's terrible.
Yeah, me too. I love it. I see a commercial and I just lose it. I go, I'm out. It's the best thing I've ever seen. I'm calling my dad immediately. Like, I love you, Dad.
Yeah, I don't know what's happening to me.
I think it's a good thing.
I spent too much time with my mom.
No, it's fantastic, and the reviews are to show for it. But basically... You're trying to get your life back, and you end up with this team, and if you win, you get some money, get to kind of get a little bit of your life back.
Yeah.
Yeah. I want to show a clip. Here's Johnny Knoxville in Sweet Dreams. Take a look.
My name is Morris, and I'm in a program, and my sponsor suggested that I come down here to tell you that I may be the person that caused all this damage to your place.
Your purple pants guy.
Yeah. And part of my recovery, if there's anything I can do to make it right, I'd like to offer that up because I'm...
Hey, Frank, you're not gonna believe this. The owner is sober.
Yeah. Johnny Knoxville, everybody! Sweet Dreams opens in theaters tomorrow and on digital April 16th. More Tonight Show after the break. Stick around, everybody. Hey, hey.